Hi, Brett McFall here with more training for you on how to create your own expert empire. In this video I'm about to let you access, you're going to go behind closed doors to my private seminar where I was showing the audience how to create their own expert empire, which means how to create their own coaching business, consulting business, information product business. And in this lesson, I want to teach you what the late, great Steve Irwin knew about marketing, but which most people don't. So I'm going to use him as the ideal person to model in this area. And you'd be amazed when you realize what was really going on in terms of what Steve Irwin was doing in his heyday. And a great man and brilliant at it. So let me explain to you now how that the lessons that you would learn from Steve Irwin can actually help you grow your business as well. All right, let's go behind the scenes now so you can see what I taught these folks about how you too can create your own expert empire. Enjoy.
Number four, stake your claim. At this point, you start and stake your claim. What is it that you're going to hang your hat on? What are you going to become known for? What is it? You know, stake your claim. Put the line in the sand. Here I am. Here's my deal. Because I'm going to ask you, what's your deal? Whenever I'm at a seminar, and are you like this too? And some person's on stage. Are you saying for the first 10 minutes, what's this guy's deal? And he or she's either got to interest you in those 10 minutes or you tune out and you respectfully watch the seminar but you're daydreaming. True or true? Hopefully not daydreaming right now. I'd be very offended, but it can happen. But I'm always asking him, okay, what's this dude's deal? And I'm trying to, what's he on about? What's she doing to say? Yeah, okay. And if he or she can get me, I'm in and I listen further. But I'm asking, what's your deal? And maybe you're asking some other question like that. But I'm going to be asking you that, what's your deal? And you should be able to tell me your reason for being. What are you the expert at? What are you the expert at? That's going to be the question. And if you don't have an answer, you don't have a business. When somebody asks me what my deal is, I'm the guy that makes internet marketing easy. I'm the guy that makes internet marketing easy.
So that's your elevator pitch, is it?
That's my elevator pitch, yeah. That's an unknown for it. Elevator pitch, yeah. What's your deal? And in fact, I think it's actually on my site. It says, the expert at making internet marketing easy, right? That's the phrase. That's my deal. That's my reason for being. That's why you would come with me. And if you cannot say that, and it's called an elevator pitch, as you may have already heard, right? Because you have about 10 to 15 seconds in an elevator to tell somebody what you do if we've got to get out, right? So what's your deal? What was this guy's deal?
Just being crazy.
Being crazy? Come on, he was more than crazy.
No, crazy fun.
Crazy fun. He's a wild, there we go, wildlife warrior. Yeah, I think that's pretty damn close.
Expert at crocodile.
Definitely the crocodile dude, right? That was his deal. And conservation, yes or yes. Who knows if Steve Irwin bought thousands and thousands of acres of Australian land to preserve? Who knows that? Who knows that? Okay, so that was his deal. That's why you know. That became his story. Didn't happen by chance. You didn't just, you know, go and research this. He made it known that so you could know it. He marketed himself so well that you know that he was actually a conservationist. Somebody had to tell his story. If it wasn't him, it was his TV programs or his wife or his kids. All pushing that one story, their deal, their reason for being. That's why you know it. And arguably one of the most iconic Australians has ever lived. Because he knew his story. He was an expert, yes or yes? He could have chosen to be an expert in iguanas, koalas. Could have chosen any of the animals. I'm sure he could have been an expert in any of them. He was just a natural, right? He chooses crocodiles because he knows you like crocodiles. He loves crocodiles. We're excited by them. We're scared of them. He's going to tame them or he's going to go and catch them. You're going to watch him catch them wild. That's his headline. And the whole reason for it, because he didn't have to create a camera, he didn't have to have a camera crew go follow him around and catch crocodiles. He didn't need the camera crew. He can catch crocodiles anytime he likes, yes? Didn't need a camera crew. The camera crew was there to document it so he could market it so he could actually get people along to Australia's zoo. He's marketing a zoo. Steve Irwin is marketing a zoo. That's his product. That's his service. You go to the zoo, you spend your money. That money then gets funded into buying land for conservation. Can you see Steve Irwin's plan here at all? It was a marketing plan. And brilliant at it. And had an awesome time along the way. So you can actually have a business, be an expert, have this awesome money come in, and be a cool dude as well. You don't have to be a knob. You can be a good person and still earn money. True or true? As long as you know that, you can still be a good person and earn lots of money, folks. What's this guy's deal? Firstly, who knows who it is? Raise your hand if you know who it is, please. Raise your hand if you know. Hey, all right. Al Gore. Vice President Al Gore. What's his deal? Climate change, conservation. How do you know that? You've seen it. You've watched it. That's his deal. That's his reason for being. To make the world aware that what we're doing is actually harming the earth. And I created an awesome presentation that he was doing for 20 years. Doing the same presentation for 20 years until somebody said, how about we film it? Gets it out to the world, becomes a top-selling film. Now we know what his deal is. He outmarketed everybody else. He outmarketed everybody else. There's many conservationists out there, yes or yes. There's a guy called David Suzuki, well-known conservationist, but couldn't do what this guy did. He packaged up his information in a way that the world's going, wow, I get it. Anybody seen the movie An Inconvenient Truth? Who's actually seen the movie? Look at the hands going up. Right? If you haven't seen it, you should check it out. It's awesome marketing. Marketing to get us to pay attention to the world. What was this guy's deal? Peace. Peace without
violence.
Thank you. Peace without violence. How many people do we know trying to have peace around here or trying to promote peace? Millions, yes? One dude stands out above all. Gandhi. Violence. Peace without violence. I could have used Martin Luther King. Same principle, right? Had the same core message. But these people, there's no gray area. They knew their message and they got it out there. Their story was out there. So you follow what the best in the world have done and you use the same for your business. You've got to know what your story is. What's your deal? Here's what I stand for. Here's what I'm about. And you will use that story over and over and over and over again. Over and over for years to come. You'll get bored of it way before your audience ever does. Your story will use forever. I've now been training people for 10 years, over 10 years now, 11 years. And I tell a story at the start of my presentation. Do you think I want to hear the story? Do you think I want to tell it? I've said it now hundreds of times, possibly 1,000 times. Do you think I want to do it again?
That's why you got the video
that
tells us.
The video tells us that. Yeah, that's right. Even with the video, I still tell the story, however. Now, why do I do that? Why do I do that?
Same consistent message.
Connects with the audience. Thank you. Connects with the audience. So here's a bit of a fact for you. Whenever I don't tell my story, sales go down. That 20 minutes of me blah-blahing decreases sales if I don't do it. So if I take the shortcut, sales go down. In fact, I was doing an event in London. There's like 8,000 people in the stadium. It's the O2 Arena. And I do my presentation, and I'm having to rush the presentation because with a big audience, all your timings go out. You can't have immediate response, so you have to wait for them to laugh, and you know sometimes people interject, and it's like it's just a bizarre phenomenon. You have to do your whole presentation differently. I didn't have the experience to do it differently, so I was doing it the same as always, and my timing was out. I was going to finish late, so I was having to rush the whole thing. I didn't do a great job of the presentation. I did a okay job of the presentation. I talked over myself. I was rushing. It was untidy, but I still did about. Jason, do you recall the sales I did at the O2 Arena? A rough number of what I generated in sales? I think it was 300 or 400, right? Something like that, $300,000 or $400,000 from a presentation that was really average. So even when you get it wrong, you can still do okay, right?
The
same as the $3,000, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Same thing, warp speed, yeah. So after the presentation, Tom comes to me. He was also speaking at the same event. He's my business partner. We talk about everything. He said, Brett, why do you have the story in your presentation? I said, I think people like to hear it. It gives them a bit of background. He says, okay. Maybe a bit long. I said, oh, okay. Thanks, Tom. Got me thinking. Going, yeah, is he right? Yeah, I think it's, I was trying to jam my presentation in. maybe he's right. If I take it out and I just have that little start video, then that's really everything I need to know. I can just get on and teach them. Logically, that makes sense, yes? So I did it. Sales went, shh, I'm going, what's happening to my sales? Same presentation, same clothes, same value, same product. I'm not using my story at the start, though. Bing, bing. Put the story back in, sales back up again. So now I tell my story, the story is always part of my presentation because it allows people to connect. The story is, it's an amusing story. I think people tend to like it. So I'm just an average dude like them and I've had some success and I can help them is the ultimate message I think gets out there. Right? Whenever I don't tell it, sales go down. So you got to have your story. You got to know your deal. You got to tell it over and over and over again.
It's no like a trust.
People buy someone from someone they trust. Good man. You got it. Yeah. Building rapport. Nice one. You get it.
Singing the same song.
I mean, do you think out the artists out there, like choose an artist that's been singing for a long time. My mum and dad went and saw Charlie Pride a few weeks back. He's a country star from long ago. They went and saw Kenny Rogers earlier in the year. Singing the same songs 20 or 30 years later. You want to hear them? I bet they don't want to sing them. I bet they don't want to sing them. Like, here we go. On a train bound for nowhere. All right. But you want it, right? You want it. And that's what an audience loves to just... I went and saw Paul Hogan Thursday night at the Gold Coast. And he's telling stories from his whole life. And he's showing snippets from his old show and everything. And he's watching. So we show some video on a screen and he's sort of showing his snippets. And he's watching it. And he's been watching this stuff for 30 years, at least 40 years maybe. We're enjoying it, but he's looking at the screen going, because it's all gone for him, right? That's all old stuff. But he has to do it. We want him to do it. We want to have that story with someone like Paul Hogan, let's say. So I'll give you some story templates because you might think, well, okay, Brett, what story will I create? There's three really good story templates. Here we go. Rags to Riches is an awesome story template. How I went from here to there. And that is the story that I use. As soon as I get on stage, I say, here's why I think you should know what I know. I failed English back in high school. And that's how I start my talk. Here's why I know. Here's how come. Here's why you should know what I know. I failed English back in high school. Bang! Rags. And I tell you about how I went through my career and couldn't pay the mortgage. Rags, right? Then I show you, bing, then something happened. To riches. And I tell them about my lifestyle now. Rags to riches. People love a rags to riches story. So if you happen to have one, we have gone from here, being low, to high, people love that. Maybe that could be your story. If that doesn't work for you, there's another template. A courageous quest. Why do you think the Rocky movies have been so successful? It's all about his quest to go from being a down and out to beat the champion. Now, when we go into the cinema, generally we know he's going to win. You watch a Rocky movie, you know, I expect him to win at the end, but I want to see the journey, the quest of how he gets there. True, true. When you watch a James Bond film, you know he's going to be alive at the end of the movie. You do know this, right? He ain't dying. But you go in there with, well, he might die. He might die, you know. I want to see how he gets out of this one. Yeah. He's on a quest. We love a quest. Lord of the Rings. It's all about the quest. As humans, we love to see people, go on a journey. We love the journey. So you might use that as your story. You might say, my quest is to create, I've heard this before, my quest is to create 1,000 millionaires, which is something which is used a lot in the marketing industry. My quest is to create 1,000 millionaires. Well, you might take that concept and adapt it to your own. My quest is to create blah, blah, blah. Doesn't matter what it is, the fact that there is a quest. I just recently ran an internet challenge. In fact, today is the last day of the challenge. And I'm not even working. I'm here teaching you instead. And that's irresponsible, don't you think? Yeah? I do. And so it's the last day of the challenge today. And so what it is, I put myself on a quest. I told people, and I'll explain to you a little bit later on here as well, I said, I'm going to take on a dude, a student. Pick him out of a hat. And for 30 days, I'm going to work with them. And the goal is to make $2,000 in 30 days from scratch. A courageous quest, yes? people started signing up. Can I be the dude? Can I be the dude? And they wanted to watch. So every week I write emails to those who actually ask for information about it, and I tell them, here's the update, here's the update. They're following me on my quest. Yeah. People love the quest, right? Prince Harry right now is on a quest, isn't he? Yep. What's his quest?
Find his wife.
No, not to find his wife, no. That's a quest of a different sort. Where is he? South Pole. And what's he doing?
Raising money.
Trying to get to the South Pole. Yeah. He wants to walk to the South Pole. We could fly him there. You know we could fly him there, right? But he wants to be on a quest because they're actually raising awareness. I think it's for soldiers who came back from the war who are amputees and things like that. I think it's to do with that sort of message. But he's on a quest. And they're using him as a marketing tool. They could do that on their own. They didn't need Harry along. But they got him along to be the marketer, to get the message out there, to raise awareness. True or true? Because we love a quest, all right? Third format would be a light bulb moment. It's where you say, you know what, I was driving along one day and I saw this, 10-year-old child on the side of the road, and he had hardly any clothes on. He was dirty. I could see he was hungry. He was skinny. And that moment, the light bulb went off. I'm not going to stand for this anymore. I'm going to do something about it. Is that a powerful light bulb moment? Right? And if you've had a light bulb moment in your life, it could be another story. Like, you know what, I was sitting in a seminar and I had a guy just chewing me out, asking me questions and getting me to trying to get me to do things. And you know what, I resisted it until one question he asked me got through my defenses. And it made me ask myself a question about what my life was about. And in that moment, my life changed forever. And my journey now, my goal now, is to show people X, Y, Z. Good or good? That can be your light bulb moment. You choose what the story is. And if it's based around reality, that'd be good. If it's based around your real story, that'd be awesome. I don't want you to make stuff up. I want it to be real. Your audience wants it to be real, and you want it to be real, because you're going to be with this sucker for a long time. It's going to be your story.